What we want to do now is to look at how the dot product would work in the context of a matrix-matrix multiply. Now remember, if you want to compute or update some element of matrix C here, then you end up taking the dot product of the corresponding row of A with the corresponding column of B. Okay, and you do this times that plus this times that plus this plus that, etc., all accumulated into an element of C. Now, the catch though here is that this now is a row, and therefore this data is not contiguous in memory. In particular, typically this will actually be a submatrix of a much larger array, as would this and this. Right? So, we need to be concerned when we implement a dot product routine, what the stride is that gets you from one element to the next within a row of A, actually within the vector X, because we are just doing a dot product of X and Y, where X happens to be a row in A and Y happens to be in a row of, in a column of B. And for that reason, what we like to do is we like to define, again, a macro, or rather two macros. The first macro would be chi of I, which would be mapped to the array X evaluated at I times some increment. Let's call that increment inc X. And that's actually how you would then get to the element in the array X that we want to index. And remember that it's always a good idea to put a parenthesis around here, because you never quite know what is being expanded in this macro. And then you would do the same thing for an element of Y. You'd call it psi of I, and that would be the array Y evaluated at I times some increment Y. And then the subroutine call would look something like, you would want to do a dot X that's added to a scalar where you pass in the number of elements in the array, the address where X is stored, together with an increment that tells you how to march through memory to get from one element of X to the next, and then Y, and the same thing, an increment for Y, and then the address of what you're trying to update with the dot product. All right? And then you would pass in the address of the first entry of the row of A with which you want to do a dot product, and the address of the first element of the column of B with which you want to do the dot product. Here, the increment would be the leading dimension of A, because that tells you by how many items you have to march through memory. And here, because we're going down the column, the increment would just be one.